Good morning. I am on a day off from work today. It is Wednesday the 5th of April. I sometimes get a day off during the week if I'm working on a Saturday, which is this week, but then it's okay because I'm off all next weekend for the long weekend and I get to go home and see everyone, so I'm really excited about that. I just thought today for a video that I would take you along my day, show you what a day in the life of me and whilst I'm on prep looks like. So include you in everything that I eat and just what I get up to. A lot of the videos that I've been watching whilst I've been doing my cardio and thing, quite often will put in a day in the life of, and I always find that quite interesting. So I'm not saying that anyone will enjoy this, but I'm sure that somebody will. I really struggle to sleep in on my days off now. I didn't used to, but I think maybe I just have, like, I have loads of energy whilst I'm on prep for now. I might not be like that in the last few weeks, but I think I had set my alarm for 8 and I was awake at like 6:45. So I've been up, I've cleaned the house, and I'm now ready to eat. Just a little update on my shoulder. So that happened last Wednesday, so it was like a week ago today. The day after I went to work, I was pretty tired, but I kind of pushed through because it was Chris's birthday. All day Friday was spent out and about, and then by the end of Friday I was quite tired, so went to bed, woke up. I was working last Saturday. By the time I got home from work on Saturday, I was absolutely shattered. So I did nothing on Saturday night, and I woke up on Sunday just feeling absolutely floored. My motivation was out the window. I had a horrible day on Sunday, so I'm not going to sit here and pretend that I'm in a good mood all the time, because sometimes I'm not. And sometimes things do get the best of me. I think I left the couch like 3 times on Sunday and then went to bed about 8 p.m. I just felt awful. But I woke up on Monday and did I train on Monday? Yes, I did. So I decided that Monday would be the first day that I got back into the swing things properly, and I wasn't sure if I would train or not. But I went to the gym and I started off my cardio for the week. Woke up yesterday morning feeling even better, so I went to the gym last night and trained legs. It's amazing how many things you need your shoulder for when you're training legs. I literally couldn't do pretty much anything. Walking lunges with dumbbells, nope. Hip thrusts, nope, because I couldn't load up the bar because it would have involved lifting weights. So I did all my leg exercises yesterday either on machines that I could just use the little knob thing to change the weights, or bodyweight exercises. I have a hip circle, so it's kind of like a resistance band that I use for lots of things. So I was doing crab walks and hip thrusts with those, but it's just never the same as doing it with a barbell. But all the same, I did more sets and more reps than I usually would because the weight was lower, and I feel fine. So I've woke up this morning, my weight's down a little bit, and I am hungry. Story of my life. So for breakfast, quite often I will either have like eggs, rye bread, spinach, turkey bacon, or I'll have a bowl of oats with protein powder, and quite often I'll just switch between the two of those, maybe like literally switch daily. However, since I hurt my shoulder last week, every single morning I've just wanted oats, so it's almost like it just feels like comfort food to me. I mean, the macros are pretty similar in both the breakfasts, but I've just gone for oats every day, and I don't think today's gonna be any different. So let's go make breakfast.
Okay, so before I eat, I usually get myself a glass, and I have some L-glutamine. That is really just for gut health, and the blue raspberry flavor tastes really good. So I have a scoop of that every morning. So I in there. As you can see, it goes a magical blue colour. I have this and I use it to take my supplements. So I take a multivitamin every morning. I get these from Ambe Direct. Vitamin D3, because vitamin D is really important, so I take one of these every single day as well. And I take 4 of these every day, omega-3 tablets, so I take those as well. Oh, my little concoction of multivitamins. Go. And drink up with this.
Another important thing that I do every morning is I have a coffee, because I would not be able to function
without coffee, and that's my coffee machine turning itself off because I turned it on about 15 minutes ago. So it's a bean to cup machine. We just buy the beans every couple of weeks, put it in, and every morning we get fresh coffee. And the best part is it cleans itself, so we don't have to clean it. So yeah, I honestly don't know what I would do without this. As you can see, I'm having a large glass of coffee this morning. I say glass, mug, in my favourite Reese's mug. So pop it under there, push that down, and the beans go in here. So we're definitely almost out. And then I would like a long coffee, thank you.
Saves my life every morning. But it's telling me to fill the tank because it's out of water. And this seems to happen to me every day. I think I'm the only one in this household who fills up the coffee tank. I shall fill up the coffee tank. Okay, so please bear in mind for anyone that is watching my video, I am obviously on a competition prep at the moment, so my calories and my macros are probably a lot lower than maybe the normal person would eat at the moment, but certainly a lot lower than what I would usually eat. This video I will put in the macros of everything that I'm eating, but don't take it as that's what you should go out and eat, because everybody is different. I'm a lot taller than your average human. I am 6 foot tall, so even when I'm on a competition prep, I'm probably eating more macros than say somebody who was 5 foot doing a competition prep. Everybody's different, everybody has a different amount of muscle mass, everybody needs different amounts of energy, everybody's body reacts in a different way. So just know that what I'm eating now is less than what I would usually eat. I'll maybe try and talk you through what a meal would look like for me in comparison when I wasn't trying to lose body fat for a competition. So time to make oats.
Okay, so in here I am gonna pour out my oats. Measly grams. On any normal day when I wasn't competing, I would have like 70 or 80 grams of oats, because carbs are my best friend. I don't have time to put things in a pan, so hot water in there and then microwave. While these are microwaving, I usually get myself a plate out and I pop my protein in here. Remember I said about how I mix it up, so let me show you how I do that. Okay, so in here I have a scoop of my ultimate favourite protein, chocolate peanut butter cup. It is literally the greatest tasting thing in the whole world. And then I just add in some hot water. Ta-da! So I'm gonna leave those there for a second. Okay, so you can see it's like a paste, just like that, and then I add the oats into the protein paste. And then, you know, like, eat the bits around the side, because who's gonna leave oats in the bowl? Now, when I'm not on prep, I would usually have some frozen raspberries in here as well.
20 grams of peanut butter coming up, and then it's breakfast time.
Right now I'm using my absolute favourite peanut butter in the whole world, Pippin' Up limited edition crunchy maple peanut butter. Mix it all together
because I'm on prep and I like to jazz my breakfast up a little bit. Sometimes I like to use my spoon that says
this is Breakfast of Champions, and it's my favourite spoon in the whole world, and Chris got it for me for my birthday,
and I feel like a champion when I'm eating my breakfast. So 40 grams of oats, 1 scoop of protein powder mixed into like a little paste, and 20 grams of peanut butter is my breakfast for today, and I'm gonna go and eat it up.
The reality of using this spoon is that it has big dumbbell on it, and it's actually really hard to eat your breakfast with. But you know, everybody loves the challenge. Oh,
breakfast is literally my favourite meal of the whole day. As soon as I finish my last meal in the evening, I'm looking forward to breakfast. In fact, sometimes once I finish breakfast, I'm looking forward to tomorrow's breakfast. After this, I'm going to the hairdressers. I wear hair extensions. Not really because I need them, because my hair is fine or short, but I got them this time last year and I fell in love with them. So then I got them again at Christmas, and ain't nobody gonna tell me that I shouldn't have hair extensions because I love them. I got another set put in it in December, so I'm going to get those removed today. I don't actually get like a full head, I literally only get like 50 buns. I'm getting the rest of those removed today because next week I'm getting my hair coloured and I'm getting a new set put in for my show. So gonna get those removed in like, yeah, like an hour, so I should probably hurry up. And if you can hear noise in the background, I'm watching Jenny McCall because I don't get time off very often. I don't sit on the couch and watch television very often. But when I do, it's usually eating my breakfast on my day off, and Jeremy Kyle's in the background. And Jeremy Kyle's a guilty pleasure. Today, my fourth wife wants to divorce me because I want to be a woman. So I'm just sitting here eating my breakfast, catching up on my social media, my messages. And I get a text from, so my show was supposed to be 21st of May. I've already booked in for my makeup and my tanning on the day of the show, so that it's just done professionally when I'm there, so that I don't have to worry about it. I've just had a text from the girl who is doing the tanning to tell me that the show's been cancelled. So she's just waiting on 100% confirmation from the people who are actually organising it, but I think, I don't know, she's seen something on Facebook which would suggest it had been cancelled. Okay. So it's not the end of the world, there are other shows. There's actually one in Scotland 2 weeks later, which I had considered maybe changing to, just given everything that's happened in the last week with my shoulder. And Chris's show is actually 3 weeks after mine was supposed to be. So again, if worse comes to worse, then I can go down and do the same show that Chris is doing, which would be fun. So if my show's cancelled, then it's not the end of the world. There are other shows out there, and we will cross that bridge when I get confirmation. So I've just had my extensions removed and I feel totally fine because my hair is actually fine. People always tell me that I don't need extensions, but sometimes want is more than need. So I want extensions and I'm gonna continue to get extensions because I love them. I'll obviously get my dead ends cut and things and get those tidied up, and then get my hair colored next Friday and get my extensions in next Saturday. Just leaving the hairdressers now. My hairdresser is actually right next door to the best donut place. Oh, that's a bold claim. Is it the best donut place in Glasgow? It's called Tantrum Donuts, and they do some really good, like, quirky donuts, like really random flavors, like pistachio, raspberry and custard, which sounds a bit rank, but actually the donuts are really good. I'm gonna go to Asda now because I need to get some things like chicken sausages and little squirty bottles of deleting juice and probably some veg, and I'm sure I'll find some other things to buy whilst I'm there. As you can probably see from my supermarket sweep, they didn't have the chicken sausages that I went in to buy, so I now need to go to another supermarket to find them. Some of you are probably sitting there thinking, just eat something else for your lunch. Well, I have two specific meal plans that I follow, and I find them, like, it just makes my life so much easier if I just follow these plans, because then we know how my body reacts to certain foods, and it means it's easier to like cut certain things out, increase certain foods, decrease certain foods. So I need these chicken sausages. And usually I have a stash in my freezer, but I don't have any left. So that was Asda. Tesco didn't have any the other night, so I think I'll go to Morrison's and hope for the best. Because I'm hungry. I'm always hungry. Even when I'm not on prep, I'm hungry.
all the time. Oh man, I was supposed to buy a bottle of water in there. Well, since it is.
I pretty much spend all my days off supermarket hopping. Here we are at Morrison's. Do you want my sausages? Then I'm out of options.
We're kind of winning, but not really, because they have some of the chicken sausages, but not the ones I wanted. So I've asked someone to go and check for me.
Okay, so Morrison's didn't have the exact type that I wanted, but I'm past caring now. The reason that I didn't want to buy the ones which I ended up buying is because they've got like a different kind of flavouring in them, which means that they have more carbs in them. On any normal day I wouldn't care, but I'm on prep, so every carb counts, and that's really depressing. So I'll just, I don't know, have like 10 grams less of butternut squash later or something, and it'll be fine. I'm gonna go home, I'm gonna cook them, and then I've got a meeting at 1:30. I do a lot of charity work for Alzheimer's Scotland, so I'm meeting with a lady who works for Alzheimer's Scotland at 1:30 to discuss some fundraising. So I'm gonna do that. Then I'm gonna meet Chris for coffee before I go to the gym, and he's going to watch Celtic play tonight, I think. I think he's going to the game at Parkhead. He might just be watching it on the telly.
Okay, so for lunch I have some spinach, some chicken sausages, and either some butternut squash or some beetroot. And then I put this in the microwave. For like a minute or something. And because I'm gonna be out and about at meeting, I'm gonna take my lunch with me, so I'm gonna pop the spinach into a tub. This stuff here, sweet and smoky shed beetroot. At the moment I'm eating 45 grams per serving, whereas before I would pretty much have had like the whole packet. Measly portions for me. I write a blog, which I will pop a link to in the description box. I'm just waiting on my chicken sausages to cook. Hurry up, hurry up! And then I will add 4 chicken sausages to my lunch, and then we'll head out.
So just waiting on these sausages to cook, and then I will add 4 to my lunch. Then I need to dash, get in the car, jump in town, park, and hope that I'm on time for my meeting. Catch you later!
Black Americano for myself and a skinny latte for Christopher.
So I'm back home now after my meeting with the lady from Alzheimer's Scotland, and I parked my car at the subway for the first time in months. Drove around for ages trying to find a street that I didn't need to pay for parking. Checked that all the other cars on the street didn't have parking payment things on them, and then came back to a parking ticket, but I was the only car on the street with a parking ticket. So I'm not happy about that. I've taken pictures of all the other cars, and I will be appealing the parking ticket, because there was no sign saying that I should have had to pay for parking, so I don't know why I had the ticket. Anyway, I'm now about to eat an Arla protein yogurt. This flavour here is a new flavour. It's called Protein Greens, and it actually sounds really rank, but I tried it for the first time the other day and I was mildly impressed. So it's mango, kale and lime flavour, and it's delicious. It actually just tastes really refreshing and yummy. So I'm gonna eat this up. Then I think I'll write a blog, because I haven't updated a blog for ages, and actually I have so much to talk about, because it turns out that my show has been cancelled. So I've had to come up with plan B today, but it's okay because we have plan B in place. So I'm gonna write a blog and then go to the gym, I think. And then I think I might actually go for a sauna tonight because it turns out that Chris is actually going to Parkhead to watch Celtic play football. So he'll be out all night and I'd just be sitting in the house by myself otherwise. So I'm gonna enjoy an evening in the sauna and steam room at my gym by myself. Sounds good. Okay, so I'm eating again. This time it's one scoop of whey protein and it's snickerdoodle flavour, which used to be my favourite. But now I've tried peanut butter cup and that's my ultimate favourite. So I'm having this and then I should really get moving because it's 6:30 and I need to get to the gym and I also want to go for a sauna. So yeah, it's not like I've been sitting here doing nothing though. I did write a blog post and I will put the link to my blog in the description box. So you can check that out if you want to. I've just been having a look at the two new different shows that I'm going to be doing since my show got cancelled. So yeah, instead of doing one, I'm now going to do two, one after the other. Well, like one week and one the next week. So that'll be fun. I'm hungry. It's starving times, but the show must go on. So I'm going to eat this and get my stuff together and go for a gym swim sauna.
I look really good. That's me just out of the gym. Did some cardio and then went for a sauna and a steam room. I haven't been for one in like months and I forgot how good they are. Except from the fact that the sauna smelt like original glazed Krispy Kreme donuts. So I don't know if somebody was trying to mess with me or if my head was messing with me or if it actually smelled like donuts. But I didn't stay in there for very long because I kept thinking about donuts. So now I'm just eating two squares of Lindt 90% dark chocolate on the drive home, and I know it's really late. It's like, well, it's like 9 o'clock, so I'll be having dinner as soon as I get home, about 9:30. I will catch up with you when I'm eating dinner and show you what is for food.
For dinner, I'm having green beans, butternut squash, and lean beef burger from Tesco.
Let me just remind you guys that I'm on a low carb diet at the moment because I'm trying to lose fat. For a show, I would usually eat pretty much like a whole pack of rice after a workout with some protein. So I'd probably have like a burger and a whole pack of Uncle Ben's. So do not attempt to go low carb unless you have a specific show or goal in mind. I'm not even really low carb at the moment. Like you've seen what I've eaten today and I still get a fair amount of carbs and I've still got a brownie to eat. Yeah, that's right. So I'll show you the brownie, but I'm not going to stall any longer because I'm hungry and it's late and I'm going to eat my dinner. So just giving you an update on what I'm having. Catch you in a bit. Okay, I really do look like death, but I apologise. So last meal of the day is Fibre One brownie, salted caramel, and a scoop of casein protein like I had in my other vlog, mixed up with a little bit of water, and I'm going to eat it. I'm also having a coffee because I'm one of these people who can drink coffee at 10:30 p.m. at night and still get to sleep, no problem. But I drink out of a straw because nobody wants to have coffee teeth. I hope that you've enjoyed finding out a little bit about what my food looks like whilst I'm on prep. Can't wait to do a food vlog when I'm not on prep because it'll be like double this. However, this is what it looks like for now. Okay, hope you've enjoyed it and don't forget to like it and subscribe. Thanks guys!